Those who have studied the cosmos even a little bit understand the immense impact of light and gravity on the known universe and our perception of it. The interaction of these two crucial facets, however, can become quite bewildering. We're familiar with notions like nothing being able to outpace the gravitational pull of a black hole, and how we tend to perceive black holes as galaxies' endgame, sucking everything with mass into their void. Simultaneously, we conceive light as consisting of massless particles, colloquially known as photons, which are universally acclaimed for traversing space at the greatest possible speed, approximately 300,000 kilometers per second. This sparks the inevitable question, how do black holes affect light if light possesses no mass? A revolutionary concept of the previous century that forms a significant pillar of Einstein's theory of relativity is that light speed is universal, remaining steady at roughly 300,000 kilometers per second. Intriguingly, this speed is the same for anyone measuring it, independent of their speed or the speed of the light source. This constancy, unlike other observable phenomena or geometrical aspects of the universe, renders the speed of light particularly special. Einstein used this premise in his special theory of relativity, where it played a crucial role in his thoughts about the geometry of spacetime and the influence of gravity and velocity-related factors on the flow of time. Einstein also presented an alternate viewpoint to Newton's traditional definition of gravity. Contrary to Newton's definition of gravity as an attractive force between two objects with mass, Einstein formulated that significant objects in the universe have the capacity to distort spacetime. This suggests that the trajectory of a thrown baseball, or similarly, the path of light, though seemingly influenced by gravity's pull, is an ever-changing straight line in the spacetime distortion. This was a groundbreaking concept in understanding the behavior of light. As light passes by black holes and navigates this distortion of spacetime, its universally constant speed doesn't accelerate. Yet, the frequency of the light changes due to this spacetime geometry distortion, demonstrating the redshift or blueshift effect. This effect drives the color transformation within the visible spectrum that we observe. Now, we've delved into how gravity wells and the vicinity of black holes influence light and its color. But let's focus on the main event. It's common to hear that the gravitational force of black holes is so intense that even light cannot break free. How does this align with what we've learned? If light can't alter its speed, then how could it be trapped by black holes? The unique characteristic of black holes lies in their event horizon, the point beyond which matter can't escape the gravitational attraction. With what we understand about blue and red light shifts, paired with the distortion of spacetime near large celestial bodies, we can theorize what occurs to light under these conditions. The closer light approaches the event horizon, the more its path bends due to the intensified spacetime distortion. This shows that under certain circumstances, light cannot escape the grip of a black hole. In essence, gravity doesn't directly influence light. It's the warped spacetime around a significant object, like a black hole, that creates an apparent change in the light's motion. At the event horizon, spacetime warps into itself. Consequently, light cannot escape a black hole once it has crossed that final threshold.